by hospitals. The MMD government, or Mr. Rupiah Banda, said the next thing is very clever. And he uses that cleverness to see what we are lacking to cheat that is addressing our problems. Comrade Rupiah Banda knows very well that at the moment, and I'm speaking for an industry which I know very well because I served in the Ministry of Health as minister for 2 years, and I understand the difficulties in this country has. What Mr. Banda and Kapekwasi Mbao first did, that's why the Rupiah Banda is very clever. He removes professionals and he puts non-professionals. He removed the branch tool from the Minister of Health and took on an engineer, Kapekwasi Mbao, so that Kapekwasi Mbao can tell him, go and dismantle equipment, they can go to UTH, remove equipment, take to Chawama. And they say they have built the hospitals or clinics. They are going to UTH, go and bring human beings. And leaving UTH with no staff. For example, when they were opening the Mwanawasa Hospital at China, they took lots of staff and equipment from UTH. But they did not have enough, because Kapekwasi Mbao is not a medical doctor, to understand what's required in a new hospital. People went to that so-called hospital, they came back with nothing. So you are not going to waste your time talking about mobile hospitals. Mobile hospital, you know, Rupiah Banda used it. He spent 53 million because he's only interested in the commission. And he got his commission and he does it because we haven't seen the service the mobile hospital is doing. We have not seen. What they have in South Africa, they have a mobile ambulance, which when there is a road traffic accident, fatal road traffic accident, they will send it there, it is equipped. They can conduct an operation within that thing inside. And it's a temporary thing to move a patient from the scene of accident to the nearest hospital. But Mr. Rupiah Banda, because he has never been serious when he was in Nambod, he has never been serious when he was governor, he has never been serious when he was MP. There is nothing he can tell us what he achieved in all of his life, apart from his broad smile on his posters, wherever you go find his Rupiah Banda's poster. Can you imagine if Kenneth Kaunda loved himself like Rupiah Banda? The amount of projects he did in Zambia, how many billboards will be going to be in Zambia? We'll run out of driving because everywhere have billboards. Now, Mr. Banda, this is same Uncle Sam, Uncle Mbama. You are talking of Zambia. This is against corruption. Zamtel was not a nuisance. Zamtel was a third telephone provider, but one which Zambians have interest in. And why transfer that thing from Zambians and send it to Libya? Because all those who are still having 0955, they are the people who are killing people in Libya. Zambians, because today there is no foreign exchange in Zambia. So the money they collect from 0955, going to kill your brothers in Libya.
Mr. Mwanga says,
Minister of Labor, I'm speaking from experience, I was once Minister of Labor, Mr. Banda, and Minister of Labor, the laws are there, but as Mr. Chota says, there is corruption. Corruption overrides, that's why the only way we can solve those things is to bring in a strong constitution. Because if you have a strong constitution, it will restrict the president's hands. If the president brings his relative, makes him permanent secretary and minister of labor, and the president brings 1,000 Chinese, there is nothing that permanent secretary is going to do. So we need a strong constitution which will limit the hand of the president, like in America where they know 4th November, on the end of the second term, there will be elections. Not Mr. Banda first slips over, he goes to Rwanda, then he comes back, he says 20th September.
So when you ask about some things like Zambia, Minister of Labor, the people in this country, we only had one referendum. That was referendum against referendum. And there are certain things, because why other people left Zambia? They were not stupid. And we will have to look at them and look at them seriously and see, is it necessary for us to sell Zambia? Because the purpose of that Zambia is supposed to provide a service where Airtel monitor cannot go. That's the purpose why we had that provided. And we have to look at that. The only thing, who is that one coming who looks like Roy Clark? Now, we will have to look at a number of these things and see whether we are being adequately served by the foreign monitors, because we know these foreign operators, their main preoccupation is money, profit. And if their preoccupation is profit, but Zambians need to communicate with their relatives. Zambians need to communicate. Previously, if a person was sick at night, you rang the police or you rang the hospital, the ambulance came. Instead of spending that $53 million buying ambulances, Pierre Banda goes to buy containers and he claims they are hospitals. These are things which we have to address. When we are talking of
in a country where those who have jobs, they will do everything to keep those jobs, corruption cannot be. What we have to do to stop corruption, the only way we can stop corruption,
we have the laws.
We know very well that the company printing the ballot papers were once involved in corruption. We know very well that one of our brothers, Mr. Fuller, was fired from ACZ because of corruption. But unfortunately, you don't expect this government to deal with that corruption. What we need is, at that time, when we said judges, civil servants should retire at a particular age, which has made majority of the people running our institutions to be on contract. If people are living much longer, and Zambia is not an island, in America, in the United Kingdom, I have my brother here, Judge Kawazo Chanda. There is no age limit for judges in the UK and in America. Because that's a job, that's a security of tenure. You find that the judges, magistrates, they are not pleasing anybody. Once they get their job, it's either their inefficiency or their age, their health failing, which will make them leave the bench. And those are things which is happening. We can have a look at them. Because today, you have a judge who is supposed to retire at 55 or 65. If he's 64, he will have to protect him to get a contract. But what we need is to bring dignity, to Zambians, because we should feel ashamed now in Zambia. We should feel ashamed